Hello, Lazzy here, and before we get into the video, I just want to make it clear to Mojang and YouTube that this is actually now legal. So this method now requires you to have a paid version of Minecraft Java Edition. So surely that means I will not receive another strike. I have recently discovered that now you can get PoJav Launcher on a non-jailbroken iOS device. So this method will support iOS 15 and above. I will be using my iPhone 12 Pro, which is not jailbroken and it is on iOS 15, just to show you that this method works. Also in today's video, I will show you how you can install Optifine and shaders for PoJav Launcher. So that is right, now you can use Java shaders on a mobile device using PoJav Launcher, which means you can get the reflections, the ultra realistic graphics, the lag, and some really awesome shaders. So unfortunately, this method does require a computer, so you can use Windows or a Mac. You will need to download an application called AltStore. Once you have downloaded and installed AltStore on your computer, all you need to do now is install AltStore on your device. And it is a quick and simple process. You just have to click install AltStore, enter your Apple ID, and don't worry, it doesn't mess up anything. I use my personal Apple ID and I've got no issues. Once AltStore has been installed on your iOS device, you need to go into settings and you need to trust the profile. So once you verify yourself, you can now open AltStore. Now the next step, we need to download PoJav Launcher. So in the description, I will link the creator's GitHub page where you can download all the latest updates of PoJav Launcher. You will need a GitHub account in order to download files. So it is a free quick sign up, which doesn't cost anything. Now, once you have signed in, go across to Actions and you will see all the release versions. Now I've just used the latest version, and all you have to do is tap on it and scroll down to the bottom. As you can see, you have all the files there for like the jailbreak side of things. But if you see at the bottom, you will see there is an IPA file. So just download it. Once you have downloaded the IPA, you just have to open it in AltStore. Keep in mind, you will need to have your computer still running at this point just so it can install. So install PoJav Launcher in AltStore. So the next step to launch PoJav Launcher, you do need to enable JIT, which is a little bit annoying. So the method I use is that in the options on AltStore, as you can see, there is a enable JIT on, I guess, my device, and I have enabled it into AltStore. Now JIT will keep on running in the background while I've got AltStore open, but if I do close AltStore, then I need to reactivate it on my computer. As you can imagine, it is a pretty tedious step, but you can actually use an alternative, which is JIT Streamer. So with this method, JIT will automatically enable on startup, and this is probably the most convenient way. But if I'm being honest, I could not figure out how to do it. So if you want to have a play around with it, all the information is on the PoJav Launcher GitHub. For myself, I have used the AltStore option. I do believe the JIT Streamer method will mean that you can use it without having to turn on your computer and enabling it like I have done through AltStore. So once JIT has been enabled, you can go back into AltStore. As you can see, I've got PoJav Launcher sideloaded on the side there, very nice. And to activate it, all you need to do is long hold on PoJav Launcher and click on enable JIT, and this will open up the application. As you can see, JIT will remain enabled until I quit the app, as I have used AltStore to enable JIT. So this is what PoJav Launcher looks like. Very sleek, if I do say so myself. You have a bit of information up in the top right corner there. So as I mentioned at the start there, you do need a Microsoft account. So I have logged in already on my Microsoft account, and it is appearing under accounts. So when you tap into it, you'll get into the next step. This is the initial startup, so it doesn't default onto Optifine. I have installed it, which I will show you shortly, but you can pick what releases you want. Now, I don't know if the latest versions work. I have not tested them out myself. I have downloaded 1.16.5, but you can download snapshots, the old beta, the old alpha. If I'm being honest, I'm not too sure if they work. And you can also install mods, like I have installed Optifine. So it has all the installed versions, which I have here. So I've got 1.16.5 and Optifine. We'll just use 16.5 just for the time being. So if you want to customize your controls, you just have to click in the top right where those three dots are. Click on custom controls and you can move around, play around with the controls in here. To get out of this page, you have to long hold. As you can see, we've got exit, save, load, add button, safe area, etc. So I'm just going to exit that. If I go into preferences, you can see all my preferences here. So I've just got the default preferences. I have changed the renderer to Zinc, which I will explain in a little bit. So once you have selected your version, you just click on play and it will start downloading. It does take quite a while to download the whole assets of Minecraft, but once you have downloaded it, you don't have to re-download it again. So we're going to launch it up and you'll see that the Mojang loading screen will load. If it stays black and doesn't load, that means JIT has not been installed and not working. But as you can see, I've got PoJav Launcher on my non
jailbroken device. As you can see, all the settings, everything's all working as you can expect with Minecraft. We will create a new world just so I can prove to you that this works. So as you can see, loading into it, a little bit of lag initially, but once it gets going, it's actually pretty playable. So the performance of Pojav Launcher is pretty good. Now I am using iPhone 12 Pro, so it is, you know, a little bit of a beefy device. However, if you are on a older device, I definitely recommend lowering that render distance because you will probably lag. So that is how you install Pojav Launcher on a non-jailbroken device. Now I will exit out and show you how to install Optifine.
Now to install Optifine or any other mods, it is really quite simple. For Optifine, you do need to download the Optifine version you have downloaded Minecraft. So I downloaded Minecraft 1.16.5, so I need to download Optifine 1.16.5. I will have the link in the description. Go onto the Optifine website and download the jar file. Once you have downloaded it, all you need to do is now go back into Pojav Launcher. Now all you need to do is go into the top right on this page where those three dots are, where we went before for the custom controls, and now you just need to click on the mod installer. When you click on this mod installer, it does open up files, and as you can see, it just automatically pops up in my recents as it is my recently downloaded file, and all you need to do is click on it. Once you click on it, it will open up into this page, and all you need to do is zoom in a little bit as it's hard to see and just click on install. It will come up with a message once it has successfully installed. Now you just have to close the application and reopen it. Now when you reopen it and go into your installed versions, as you can see, I've got Optifine installed, and you can click on it and it will run and open. With Optifine installed, you can play around with the settings, you know, turn off some stuff, so hopefully it reduces the lag and you get that Optifine zoom, which is really awesome. Now with Optifine installed, we can now install shaders. So I will show you now how to install shaders on Pojav Launcher on a non-jailbroken device. Now to install shaders is really simple. You need to download the shader first. So I have linked in the description the shaders I have used in today's video. These I've tested out and they seem to be working for myself. They do lag. Few bugs here and there, but they ultimately work. So once you have downloaded your shaders, just go into downloads. As you can see, I have downloaded a bunch of shaders here. Not all of these work. Keep in mind, Project Luma just crashed, and I think Sora shaders crashes as well at times. But once you have downloaded your shaders, so for example, Super Duper Vanilla and a Kirkpatrick shader I have downloaded. Now you just need to copy them. And now go back to on my iPhone or iPad, depending on what device you are on. And as you will see, that Pojav Launcher now has its own folder. So you need to click onto it. And as you can see, we have some more folders in here. You have to scroll down till you see instances, click on defaults, and you'll have a bunch of folders and options in here which you can play around with if you do install like the mod installer. This is where all the mods would get put. But with Optifine installed, a new folder appears, which is Shader Packs. Now I already have the shaders in here as I was experimenting to see which one works, which one lags, and which one crashes. So all you need to do is place it in here. So I'll just paste it. It'll say they're duplicates and I'll just replace it, or not. It'll just create a duplicate of it. Now the next step is very crucial, as I missed this step, and as you can see, it broke the shaders. The shaders will not work if you miss this step. In Pojav Launcher, before you launch Minecraft, go into preferences and change the renderer. You need to click on Zinc. Once you have enabled Zinc, you can go and launch the Optifine version of Minecraft. So just like Java Edition, because it is literally Java Edition, you now need to go into the Optifine version of Minecraft. Once it has loaded, go into settings and you will see the shaders folder. Click in here and this is where you enable your shader packs. Once you enable the shader packs, you can still edit the shader settings in the app. I have changed the profile to low just to reduce some lag. Well, it still lags, but to reduce lag on the mobile device. But you can play around with it, see if Ultra works, or just to see what kind of shaders work on your device. Once you have the shader equipped, you can launch up your world and experience Minecraft Java shaders on a mobile device. So that is a tutorial on how to install Pojav Launcher on your mobile device without jailbreak. This works on all the new versions of iOS, so iOS 15, iOS 14, etc. If you did learn something new in today's video, a like is always appreciated. Make sure you subscribe and turn on those notifications, because I do plan on doing some more Pojav Launcher videos. I will do a mod showcase with an installation guide tutorial video coming shortly as I play around with it myself, as I recently just discovered this. Massive shout out to the Pojav Launcher creators. I will link them in the description. Go follow them, support them, because it is mind-blowing that they have been able to port Minecraft Java Edition over to a mobile device, which is unbelievable. It's seriously so mind-blowing. All the links to Optifine shaders I have used will be in the description below, but that is it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next one, and peace.